Look at this picture. What do you find over here? If you place a candle in front of a mirror, what will you see? You will see that an exact image of the candle you can see on the mirror. So how do you think this is happening? How do you think that the candle that you're placing in front of the mirror is forming an image on the mirror? Let us find out. Look at the diagram that has been represented on the board. Here, the candle is represented by this circle. So what we are going to try and do now is obtain an image for this candle on the mirror PQ. So to form an image, we are going to need at least two rays coming from the candle onto the mirror. So these rays have been depicted by these two arrows. These two rays are the incident rays because they are coming from the candle and they are hitting the mirror as depicted by these arrowheads. So after these incident rays come and hit the mirror, what will happen? They will bounce back. So after these rays bounce back, that is, after they are reflected, they reach the observer's, or in this case, the human eye. Now, do you think that the human eye is able to trace this V path? It is not. The human eye cannot trace the V path that the incident ray and the reflected ray is taking. So, how does the human eye see the image? The human eye always perceives the image to be coming from a straight line. That is, the human eye perceives that the image is at this point. Because, like I mentioned, the human eye cannot perceive this V path, it always perceives that the image is coming in a straight line path. So how are we getting this image? Let us find out. We are obtaining the image on the mirror by extrapolating these reflected rays. What is the meaning of extrapolating? We are producing them backwards. So from these two points, we are producing the reflected ray backwards, and we find that these reflected rays appear to be diverging from this point. Thus, we get the image of this object O, that is the candle, at this point shown by I. And as you can see, the image is formed behind the object on the mirror. It is formed behind the object on the mirror. So what did we learn? We learned that when you place any object in front of a mirror, you are able to see its reflection. How do you see its reflection? How can you find it out diagrammatically? By drawing a diagram of an object placed in front of a mirror, you need at least two rays. These two rays, after reflection, will appear to be diverging from a point that is behind the mirror. This is because the human eye cannot perceive this V path. The human eye always perceives things in a straight line. Due to this, the image appears on the other side of the mirror.